United Methodist, Camp Magruder, Bay City, and Nehalem Bay United Methodist. As always, we will start with a few technical needs. If you go to the upper corner, you will see the speaker view. If you click on that, you'll be able to see who is speaking as the large box, and then all of the rest of the folks in the congregation will be across the top. Then if you go down to the bottom middle, you'll find the chat. Now, one thing before we go to the chat, you'll also see this green thing that says screen share. Please don't click that. But you will have the chat, and you can go down to the bottom of the chat area when you click on that and type in your prayer requests. And we promise you that we will get to those during the course of the service. Today's, we're having scripture read by Mary Reef with Ray Norgard leading our call to worship, Steve and Nancy Kershaw leading our prayer time. Patty Porter will be reading the prayer request. Janine Seidler will lead our community journal, which will feature Jenny Myers, Roberta Bettis from Bay City United Methodist, and Jan West from Nehalem Bay. This is Communion Sunday. Communion is the Lord's Supper. It is the rite that unites us across time and space with all who have ever participated and all who ever will. Participating in our great Thanksgiving are Debbie Hendrickson and Peter Nunn. That prayer will be followed with a contemplative piece of music. And during that time of music, we invite you to consume the bread and the juice, the coffee and the bagel, whatever you may have with you. And now I invite you, let us worship God together.
Come all who are weary, come to the Lord of healing love.
Lord,
we who are weary in spirit come to you.
Come all who are burdened, struggling with events of life which weigh you down.
We come bearing gifts.
Bearing burdens of all kinds, we seek peace.
Come all who doubt, who are puzzled, who are fearful.
We come wondering if it is possible to be healed of our pain, to lay our burdens down and find peace.
We gather today, this morning, O Lord, eager to feel your healing touch for our wounded spirits and weary souls. Flood our lives with your peace. Shine your light of joys in our souls this day, for we pray in Christ's name. Amen.
Thank you. Good morning. Aloha. That is the word for this week. Today's community journal is a sharing of a few of our members of the Luke's Gospel titled The Parable of the Great Banquet. The theme of hospitality presented in this scripture asks us to examine how do we welcome others to our community. And how do we receive hospitality from those who offer it to us? This is our first attempt to include short videos from our entire church community into our community journal, and we welcome you to consider doing this in the future. I'm so happy today to say that we will hear first from Jenny Myers. Jenny is familiar to all of you as our wonderful pianist. She is the coordinator for worship music for the Nehalem Bay United Methodist Church and all of us here. She serves on the leadership team and she will be the chair of that group in the coming year. Jenny is a delightful addition to any room she enters. Next, we will hear from Roberta Bettis. She is a sixth generation Methodist who feels the Wesleyan call. She is the lay leader, treasurer, social media coordinator, and video technology manager for Bay City United Methodist Church. She has been streaming their services online for 4 years. I talked to her yesterday and I'm quite impressed. Last, we'll hear from my dear friend and neighbor, Jan West, a longtime member, and Jan will be introducing herself. And now Pastor Steve will share those videos with us.
So our theme today is hospitality. And we are very hospitable at church when we're all there, able to hug each other and say good morning and fill out our little yellow slips that tell us who you are. However, we have no yellow slips and we can't hug each other and we can't say, hey, we're really glad you're here. Who are you? So our dilemma is, how are we going to welcome and make people feel welcome and acknowledge them when they're new? Think about it.
Gosh, when I hear this scripture from Luke, my mind is just wide open to all the possibilities of what it can mean for me and for the family of Christ in the world. I mean, what if on my way to Tillamook, I stopped and asked the girl who was waiting for the bus to join me at the banquet? And what if I stopped in Fred Meyer and asked that frazzled mom and her 4-year-old to join me at the banquet? And what if I stopped on my way out of the driveway at Fred Meyer and asked the guy who's standing there with his sign that says, spare change for a ride to Portland? What if I stopped and asked him to the banquet? What if I could share with them all the banquet that is God's love that Jesus is talking about? I've widened the community of Christ and welcomed new people to the table and gotten to know God a little better and gotten to know Jesus Christ a little better. And they've gotten to know the body of Christ a little better because they've been at the banquet with one another and they've been at the banquet with all of us.
I'm Jen West, a retired nurse and married to Don West, who was the pastor of this church in Nehalem for some years. We moved here in 86 through 91 and then came back again to make our home here in 1997. At the time that we came back, we found again a loving and caring congregation who nurtured us and welcomed us and hugged us. You remember hugs. They're really nice. Also, we joined a Bible study group in the last 2 years since Steve Wolf has been here and met around a table. And the first question we always asked is, how is it with your soul? And people could freely and openly and safely discuss that in the group. And then we studied Bible passages that we had prepared ahead. Then COVID. Now here we are, online. I hardly know what to say, except that the hugs, virtual hugs, aren't quite as good as touching each other, but that will come back someday, we hope. In the meantime, we are looking for ways to extend the hospitality of this Zoom meeting to more and more people. And if you're new to us, we would love to hear from you. You can email us, watch for the email during the end of the session, or you could just hold up a slip of paper in front of you that said, "Hi, I'm new and I'm from," and put it on the up in front of you when you come online. In any case, you are welcome. We want to send our love and hospitality. Don't forget that we have a huge prayer group. So if you know you have a need of any kind, or any friends of yours do, please include a prayer request during our service. And we'll look forward to seeing you again and again, and someday perhaps in person. God bless you and be well.
Thank you all for sharing that message. I also want to thank Craig West for letting this happen this morning. He made such a big effort to help us have his mother filmed. It was really heartwarming for us. I wanted to share with you a little bit about my own story here and tell you that I have experienced many, many instances of hospitality during my first year as a member of Nehalem Bay United Methodist Church. From the moment I entered the church last June, I was invited to lunch afterwards, and I have felt welcomed and supported every minute since then. I actually live here because of this church. Mine is the lovely story of a tired traveler who was invited to the banquet. I found this church after 2 years on the road, and I have come all the way from Baltimore, Maryland. Belonging to this community is the richest blessing I could ever be granted, and that sense of belonging is one that I want to share with each of you. Whether we ever meet face-to-face or just through Zooming, I hope you will know that you are welcome here. Later in the announcements, you will hear an invitation to participate, where we will give you the opportunity to find a way to reach out to us and get to know us better. Next, we will hear the reading of the Luke scripture, the parable of the great banquet.
One of the dinner guests, on hearing this, said to him, "Blessed is anyone who will eat bread in the kingdom of God." Then Jesus said to him, "Someone gave a great dinner and invited many. At the time for the dinner, he sent his slave to say to those who had been invited, 'Come, for everything is ready now.' But they all alike began to make excuses. The first said to him, 'I have bought a piece of land and I must go out and see it. Please accept my apologies.' Another said, 'I have bought 5 yoke of oxen, and I am going to try them out. Please accept my apologies.' Another said, 'I have just been married, and therefore I cannot come.' So the slave returned and reported this to his master. Then the owner of the house became angry and said to his slave, 'Go out at once into the streets and lanes of the town and bring in the poor, the crippled, the blind, and the lame.' And the slave said, 'Sir, what you ordered has been done, and there is still room.' Then the master said to the slave, Go out into the roads and lanes and compel the people to come in so that my house may be filled. For I tell you, none of those who were invited will taste my dinner."
Well, we're going to start by taking a few moments to talk to one another. In a moment, we're going to go into breakout rooms. Now, those of you who are here by telephone, you don't have to worry. You will automatically go to the breakout room. The rest of us will receive an invitation into the breakout room, just like the Great Banquet. We have to accept the invitation. Please click on the place that says yes. Accept the invitation. No excuses. When you get there, you'll have 4 minutes to talk to each other about what is hospitality. So do talk to each other. And what the heck, in keeping with today's scripture, go ahead and come up with a few good excuses too if you want to. At the end of 4 minutes, you will magically be transported back into our main meeting room again. So initiate the breakout rooms and send everyone there. Now, as with all technology, it takes just a second.
Honey, you have to come and do this. I don't know how. Okay, we're doing breakout room, and now's the time.
All right.
Oh, look at that. Yeah. Good one.
Yeah.
All right. Jeannie and Robin, did you not go to a room?
We don't know how to do anything.
Oh, that's okay. Okay.
We don't know how to do it, but we don't even know how to turn it on. I'm sorry.
Okay, that's okay.
Jeannie doesn't know how either. We're so tech savvy here at the home.
Happy you're here.
Glad to be here.
Do we press join?
Yes, you do. You press join. Stephen, can you press join? Linda Valdez, can you press join? You see the join button? Sue, can you press join? Steve and Sue, Pastor Steve's waiting for you in breakout room 9. Steve, do you see the join button? Linda, can you see the join button? Welcome back.
Well, everyone's coming back. We were just getting into, I got to switch back to my other camera now. There we are.
Allergies.
Yeah. Hi there. Well, let's see. I think they're all muted at the moment, but I was going to take a moment to let you all say what you found out about hospitality while talking to each other. So if I could ask our host maybe to just unmute for a moment.
I did. Don't
be carried away. Welcome back. So what did you hear from each other about hospitality? What did you all hear from each other about hospitality? What is hospitality?
I learned something, but I can't say it because I'll give away the sermon.
Well, there is that too,
yes. So Jane had some wonderful ideas.
Uh-huh.
Go ahead. About sharing the link for the service with people who come into the food pantry.
Oh.
At church, and have it available for the Grub Club people, or even have something in the food bags about connecting to worship, or just thinking if we're thinking about them and praying for them.
That's great.
Yeah.
Andy and I talked about maybe advertising at the end of the service that we're going to have a gathering in the church parking lot. Everybody bring a chair, put it at the end of your car, and have a chat.
Nobody can hear.
Huh?
Nobody can hear each other from 6 feet away.
Now you're starting to all talk over each other again. Did anybody come up with any good excuses?
No.
Oh, okay.
No, but we did talk about the fact that an element of refusing hospitality is also something that we need to be careful that we don't refuse hospitality when it's offered.
Yeah.
When you're on the other side and you're the receiver, it's important to realize that it's being offered to you. I think that was the main message in the scripture.
Marty, thank you for a wonderful segue. I'll ask our host to mute everybody now.
Marty or Shill?
and the check is in the mail. A minute to highlight a view of hospitality we don't think of very often. Now, one of my teachers, who was a preacher, Fred Craddock, told a story once about Ralph Abernathy. Abernathy was a close friend and a mentor of Dr. Martin Luther King when King was a young pastor in Montgomery, Alabama. After the Montgomery bus boycott, King insisted that Abernathy move to Atlanta so they continue working together on civil rights. So Abernathy became the senior pastor at West Hunter Street Baptist Church in Atlanta. Well, in the 60s, people would come to church to hear Abernathy preach, expecting to hear about the civil rights movement. What Abernathy preached was the gospel. And this was confusing to many of them because they weren't that familiar with the gospel. So they would come to Abernathy after the service and say, well, we thought you were going to speak about civil rights today, not the Bible. And Abernathy would respond, oh, you're interested in being part of our social action committee. Here, let me show you where you can sign up. Yeah, I know that doesn't immediately sound like hospitality, even though it is the gospel. But what if hospitality is not something I show you? What if hospitality is not something I expect from you? What if hospitality is something that we do together? Look, one of the things that confuses people about this parable is, why would anybody turn down a free meal? And apparently a really good one. I mean, it was a rich man. Well, say the commentators, this was a society of obligations. If you accepted an invitation to a banquet, you were then obligated to return the invitation to an equally lavish banquet. And since this was a very rich man, nobody wanted to be obligated to put on a banquet at that fancy. So they had excuses. And in retaliation, the rich man invited those who could not possibly return the invite, showing just how gracious God is. And that is true. But think, what if the inhospitable act was refusing to form community with the rich and with the lame and the poor and all of those others? Community is not a two-way street of obligation. It's something that we create together. So if that's the case, then in this time of pandemic, wearing a mask is not an issue about liberty or freedom. It's not about protecting me from you or even you from me. The mask is a symbol of community, taking care of that space where we meet, the space between us. And if that's the case, we're no longer practicing social distancing. We're living it. It's no longer the new normal versus the old normal. It's our normal. And as we're dealing with the racism and privilege that is in the very DNA of our society, it's not a matter of just saying, well, Black Lives Matter or Blue Lives Matter or All Lives Matter. Hospitality is about allowing ourselves to be led by the least likely people. Do not insist that we know the way, but just to stand with all the people living in the highways and the hedgerows. Here, let me show you what I mean. I saw this sign the other day from one of the protests. I understand that I will never understand, but I will stand with you. Hospitality is showing up for the banquet, even when it isn't our banquet. And that's just not something we have a lot of experience doing. So our word today is aloha. Excuse me, aloha. Aloha is an unincorporated part of Washington County between Beaverton and Hillsboro. Our word today is aloha. And it fits this very well. It's both a word of greeting and a word of sending. It's a word of binding. It literally means in the presence of breath or the breath of life. Aloha is a way of living or treating one another as if community was the essence of life itself. And it seems to me that that is what hospitality is all about. Amen.
Good morning. Now is the time for our prayers, concerns, and joys. And Janine Seidler offers prayers of thanksgiving for the safe return of Vincent Seidler and her friend Flame's return to Boulder. And Nancy and Steve Kershaw ask for continued prayers for Alyssa Kershaw and her doctors, and the fact that they're having three new tests and some appointments this week, and hopefully they will be able to know more by the end of the week. And I ask for continued prayers for our country, for peace and healing and compassion.
Nancy. So at this point, if you would join me in the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
I think so. But...
That's not what I have.
I see you at the end.
On this lovely day, at the end of the month of June, we praise and thank you, O Lord. We bring before you our gifts, our lives, our talents. Take all these gifts and use them for work in your kingdom. Bless the gifts and the givers of all gifts. Amen. I don't think that's the right spot.
We'll go on.
Okay, so I have the prayer. Merciful and loving God, we are grateful for your redeeming love for each one of us. We confess that there have been times of doubt in our spirits. We confess that when the times of difficulties are upon us, we don't always believe that you will take our burdens. We feel we have to always be in control, trying to demand the desired outcome. Help us to place our trust in you. And if it were on the screen, you could read along with me. Remind us that you surround us continually with your care. You never just let us go to drift aimlessly about. Open our hearts and spirits again to your healing powers. For we pray these things in the name of Jesus, the one who will take our burdens and give us peace. Amen.
Thank you. Amen.
People respond, and also with you. Lift up your hearts. And the people say, we lift them up to the Lord.
We lift them up to the Lord.
To the Lord our God. And together we respond, it is right to give God thanks and praise.
God of twinkling stars and swirling galaxies, of mud puddles and mighty oceans, God of newborn babies and wise elders, God of wonder and grace, you began by creating. You created the wonders of our universe. Cold, barren planets, and planets teeming with warmth and water and life. You created us, your precious children, from the stuff of the earth, grounding us in the awesome power of nature. And you breathed into us your very spirit breath, sharing with us your sacred creativity. You created us in rich diversity, in race, gender, abilities, gifts, and graces. You called us to do justice and love mercy, and to walk in your ways.
You gave us neighbors and called us to love them.
to love all of them. He taught us about justice and charged us with sharing the bounty of the earth. In the fullness of your time, you took on our human form and lived among us, showing us how to love deeply and live gently. You fed the hungry, healed the broken, restored the lost. You chastised the leaders for their lust for power and wealth. You condemned their failure to care for the suffering and challenged them to free they oppressed.
As your life and work among us drew to its close, you gathered your friends together and shared with them your vision for their life and ministries. You shared a last meal together. At that table, you took bread, blessed it with thanksgiving. You passed it to your friends, saying, "Take, eat. This is the bread of life." At that meal, you also took a goblet of wine. After blessing it with thanksgiving, you shared it with your friends, saying, "Take and drink from this. It is the cup of the new covenant. It is my love poured out for you." In this sacrament, we remember all that you have done and continue to do for us, your life, suffering, death, and resurrection. God of love and justice, pour out your spirit on your gathered people and on these gifts. Let them be for us the very presence of Christ, so that we may go from this table and be the presence of Christ in each encounter of our lives. Unite us in communities of justice. Give us the grace to be one with all of our neighbors and to unite in the fullness of your community of love, justice, and grace. Amen. I invite you now to partake of the fruit of grain and vine as you listen to this beautiful music. The piece is a bit long, so just relax into meditation and enjoy the community of the saints.
Now, may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the face of God shine upon you. And may you know peace. Amen. I'm afraid, Jenny, you're going to have to unmute yourself. There you, oops. Join us next week at the same time in the same place. The invitation that brought you here today will work this week, but we will continue to post on Facebook and BBQ as well. Our facilities and buildings are still limited to 10 people at a time for essential services only, such as preparing for Grub Club or our food banks. But even though our buildings are closed, the church is open, and we are still deeply involved in supporting our communities by working with varieties of partners, including Camp Magruder, particularly around food insecurity through our time with so many layoffs. You can participate financially by sending a check to the church office or by donating through the Give Plus app. We also will, in a moment during our announcements, you will be hearing about some of the other opportunities that you may have to participate in this. During the summer, we're going to be following the PeaceWorks curriculum that our camps would be using if they were in their normal times. If you haven't gotten a copy of those scriptures yet, please be in touch with the church office. And we will be having next week's posted during our announcements in just a moment. We are committed to having as many of our community voices in our worship service as possible. So if you have 30 seconds or a couple minutes of thoughts or response to the scripture for the week, as you saw today, record those on your phone, email them to the church, to the Nehalem Bay Church email address, and we will get them into our worship service. Stay tuned now for the